I'm gonna put like a 10 Allen in there.
Oh, I was out of range. Okay, we gotta let him leave now because I got beat up. No! Whatever. I was gonna try to sneak back around and take the elevator, but... Oh well. Yep. Gotta have our, end of day smoke. Little bird, come here. I'm tired. I said come here. Yes, father. What do you want? Why do you want to talk to the administrator? You made me. You want me to shut up? What have I done? Well, first of all, you don't let me sleep. I do it for your own good. You're ungrateful. Go away. Don't overdo it. Go away? He just told me to come here. I only receive pain and humiliation from you. You'll be the death of me. Oh, that's kind of the idea. I hate you when you're like this. What is going on with this conversation? A package has been delivered. Phone is ringing. No, let's take care of that. Howard the Carpenter. I'm actually kind of looking forward to this. What kinds of things can we buy from the carpentry store? We're going to find out. Hello? Hello? Oh, I hate those things. Can you hear me? It's Howard the Carpenter. These dang fangled new technology things. Rotary phones. I'm going to retire soon, and I'm looking for someone to take my place. There's a lot to do, and these youngsters don't know how to do anything. I need good tools and components. Can you bring them to me? I don't know who to turn to. A saw and glue. Okay, but nothing is done for nothing. Yeah, but don't do anything stupid. You can find me here at the carpenter's shop in Swords End, facing the Zavtra River. Dorothy the Flower Lady. Okay. What exists only before birth and disappears just afterward. I am Dorothy the Flower Lady from Al Sadaka. Are you the Patcher? Okay, the Patcher, sure. Be nice and bring me some monster's parts for my boudoir, would you? A tongue and excrement. I can probably do that. Nothing is done for nothing. Explain yourself. Do you mean you want something in return? Oh, sure. You'll get your reward. Come see me at the flower room in Al Sadaka. Hello, little bird. Can you stay with me today? How can you think something like that? You could forget your job every now and then and rest. Yeah, exactly. When I'm on the rise. What do you do all day? I increase my credit level. Credit level? What's that? It'd be difficult to explain it to someone like you. Let's just say that it's something that makes you important. Every time I successfully complete a task, my fame and therefore my credit rise. The more credit I have, the more people will pay for my services. Moreover, by increasing my credit level, everything I own rises in value. It's all because it's me and not any other one. You get it?
That's all you do?
I also increase my estate. That is the sum of the value of the things I own. Why am I telling you this?
It was very interesting.
Okay. So the chasm is mostly like a tutorial thing, right? My credit level is 8. Can you bring me there now? Sure, sir. Please, do come aboard. Dear travelers, the elevator is about to leave. All companions are invited to disembark. Keep the legs slightly spread during the ascent for greater stability. Next up, Penthouse. How fast does this elevator move? Ooh. Ah. The sky has a worrying color. Okay. Geraldine? That's probably not the correct way to pronounce that.
Geraldine.
Geraldine. I don't know. I wonder where that scoundrel is hiding. I knew that smell, small ear was nothing but trouble. Why are they all rabbits as well? Okay, small ear. So someone is not a rabbit, possibly. Vernon, the administrator will never forgive us. Oh no, what did you do? Bell jar. Is there supposed to be a rose in there or something? Get out! Who knows what there was in this bell jar? Odette. It's a catastrophe. We're ruined. Well, you could tell me. This city has a worrying color. Can't do anything with the book. Isolde. Isolde? Or Isolde. Good evening. I'm a tenant in the condo. I'd like to speak with the administrator. What do you need? I'd like to denounce the presence of a chasm in my condo. And while I'm at it, the inappropriate behavior of the concierge. Yeah, he just sweeps the same spot. He never actually sweeps in front of my door. The administrator is on vacation. You'll have to come back later. It's urgent. Can I reach him somehow? Unfortunately, no. The administrator is unreachable. Excuse me, but I have to go. We have an emergency. What kind of emergency? Someone stole something from the administrator. A theft in the condo? Unbelievable. Do you know who's responsible for it? A small ear who worked here. Both him and the bonsai disappeared, coincidentally. The bonsai was stolen? Yes, and if we don't get it back in 10 days, we'll be in trouble. Why 10 days? Because in 10 days, the administrator will come back, so he wrote. Where? On a note. Where was this note? On the bonsai. Oh, junk. The owner of the bonsai is the administrator? I have your bonsai. Thief! Thief! Please, thief, don't hurt me. What did I expect? I mean, look at those ears. Surrender it now. Of course, but I believe I deserve something in turn. He's asking for a ransom. He's asking for a ransom. Ransom? I'm asking for a reward. A thief doesn't deserve a reward. Me? A thief? I've taken care of it. If it wasn't for me, who knows what would have happened to it. Please, thief, give it back. The administrator is jealous of his things. Give me a reward first. Reward? You deserve a complaint. Did I read that wrong? Let me talk to the administrator then. You can't. You can't. The administrator is unreachable. I'll keep the bonsai until I get my reward. You're blackmailing us. That's exactly what a small ear would do. He has to give it back. He has to give it back. Calm down, everyone. It's true that the administrator is not here, but we can always check the regulations. After all, they've been written under his supervision. So, if there's no other choice... This is a very strange conversation. Here it is, Chapter 7, Property Disputes. Article 12, the person who comes into possession of a stolen item shall give it back to the rightful owner. See, you have to give it back. Let me see. Paragraph 2, the person who gives the stolen item back is entitled to a reward. Paragraph 4, the person who asks for a reward has to prove beyond all reasonable doubt that the item wasn't stolen by them. I didn't steal it. The bonsai was left at my door. Are there any witnesses? Can you prove it? Alfred! I could, if only Alfred knew how to do his job. I'm sorry, then, but you have to give it back. It's written in the regulations. It's not possible. Let me see that. Read here. The person who cannot prove to not be the perpetrator can make a purchase offer in good faith. That settles it, then. I'll buy it. You can't buy it without the administrator's permission. Who says? The regulations. Here. The price of the item and the requirements needed to buy it have to be established by the rightful owner of the stolen item. The owner is the administrator, but he's on vacation. We'll have to wait for him to come back. The administrator is a liar. He doesn't want to come back. How dare you? Here, it reads that, shall the owner be absent, the price of the item and the requirements needed to buy it can be established by the owner's legal representative. Who's the administrator's legal representative? The notary. Bring him to me. But it's written in the regulations. Okay, follow me. What the heck? I enjoyed that probably more than I should have. sold it. After you,